Mark Twain said, "India is the cradle of the human race, the birthplace of human speech, the mother of history, the grandmother of legend, and the great-grandmother of tradition. Our most valuable and most artistic materials in the history of man are treasured up in India only." Yes, we see that India is a land of diversity. India is a kaleidoscope of different culture that includes various things like tourism, legends, talking about the previous days, the traditions, the glimpses. In total, we see that it is just a variety of spices. And we see that it's one of the oldest civilizations in the world and boasts of many ethnic groups following different cultures and religion. And apart from all these things, the immense unity in diversity makes India an example of cultural brotherhood. Dear children, you're going to learn about glimpses of India. In glimpses of India, you have a baker from Goa, Coorg, and tea from Assam. In this, we can see that first of all, you're going to learn the lesson a baker from Goa from the glimpses of India. A Baker from Goa was written by Professor Lucio Rodrigues. This Professor Lucio Rodrigues is a literary genius from Goa. His legacy of literature lives on through his writings and his students. He is considered to be an authority on Goan folklore, and he was considered to be a visiting professor of folklore at the Indiana University, USA in 1969. His essays in English as well as those translated from Konkani were published as Of Soil and Soul and Konkani Folktales. He died in the year 1973. So, first part of A Glimpses of India is A Baker from Goa. As I told you, this part of the lesson focuses on the time when Portuguese ruled Goa. As we go through the lesson, we see that the life and picture of Goan bakers were highlighted, and the writer is portraying a time when loaves of bread played a vital role in Goan's life. It just gives the traditional Goan bakers who still hold an important place in Goa society. Okay? So first part of A Glimpse of India is A Baker from Goa. Students, take your textbook. Let's deal with the text. Okay? A Baker from Goa. Our elders are often heard reminiscing nostalgically about those good old Portuguese days, the Portuguese and the famous loaves of bread. Those eaters of loaves might have vanished, but the makers are still there. We still have amongst us the mixers, the molders, and those who bake loaves. Those age-old time-tested furnaces still exist. The fire in the furnace has not yet been extinguished. The thud and jingle of the traditional baker's bamboo heralding his arrival in the morning can still be heard in some places. Maybe the father is not alive, but the son still carries on the family profession. These bakers are even today known as padar in Goa. Okay, so coming to the lesson, we see that the first part, The Glimpses of India. Here we see some kind of people, their image, everything, especially the memory of baker. From where? From Goa. A baker from Goa. Here we see that our elders are often heard reminiscing. What is reminiscing? Reminiscing means thinking, remembering with great pleasure about the past, especially the time of Portugal rule. And the love of Portuguese towards bread. Okay, loaves of bread. Okay, so this part is being remembered even now in places of Goa. Okay, and we see that these Portuguese were considered to be the lovers of loaves of bread. And they are now vanished. Vanished means they went from Goa. Now we are free. And we see that now no more Portuguese are ruling this Goa. But still then the elders of this Goa continue talking about the time when Portuguese were ruling this Goa and their more love and interest towards bread. Okay, maybe this is the time when Govan Bilkas were more prominent and they have great role. They have got great role in Goa. But still then the narrator says that even now, in this century also, they have very good importance where? In Goa. And says that nothing can replace this furnace. Furnace where the bread is baked. Even the mixers, molders, everything are there. There are so many people who bake the laws also. Laws means bread. But still then, this age-old time-tested furnace where this bread is baked still exists. And nothing can replace this furnace with mixers or molders. Okay? So anyhow, this bread, loaves of bread has now been a part of the life of Goa people. And now here talking about the people, it says that the Govan Bilkas, they are called as Padas. Padas is a name of bakers in Portuguese. In Portuguese language, Padar means baker. Okay, one who bakes bread. Okay, and now here we see that even now the thud and jingle of the traditional bakers can be heard in where? In Goa city, on the places of Goa. Okay, and we see that the bakers, the people who bakes this bread, they are doing it as a traditional job, as a professional traditional job in their life. An earlier time, it was done by their fathers or great grandfathers. But still then, the son or the grandson of the family still continue doing this job because it's a part of their tradition. It's a traditional job. Okay. And also we see that the making and the distribution of this bread remains just like the ancient time. So that's why it says that the arrival of the Govan bakers just announces by the thud and jingling sound of the bamboo stick. That means these bakers are coming to each place by making a music, okay, with a musical note. So that's where it says that they announce their arrival. Here it says that the thud and jingle of the traditional baker's bamboo, heralding means announcing. Whenever a baker is coming to the village with loaves of bread, he will be having a bamboo stick in his hand and he just gives a thud. That means he just makes sound with the help of this stick on the ground, as well as a jingling or music is also there. So hearing the sound of the bamboo stick as well as the jingling sound of the music, everyone will know that who is coming. This baker or these padas are coming. Okay. And that shows that even now these padas have great demand where? In Goa. And they are just doing this even today, and they are known as padar in Goa. Padar means a baker in Goa. Now coming to the next paragraph. During our childhood in Goa, the baker used to be our friends, companion and guide. He used to come at least twice a day, once when he set out in the morning on his selling round, then again when he returned after emptying his huge basket. The jingling thud of his bamboo woke up from the sleep and we ran to meet and greet him. Why was it so? Was it for the love of the loaf? Not at all. The loaves were brought by some Paskine or Bastine, the maid servant of the house. What we longed for those bread bangles were, which we choose carefully. Sometimes it was sweet bread of special make. Now the narrator says that he remembers and he is just loved to remember the arrival of these bakers in his childhood days. And he remembers that in our childhood, bakers used to be our friends, companion and guide. These small children of that area love to see these bakers, fathers. Okay? Whenever they come making the sound with the bamboo stick and a special music, even though the children were sleeping, they used to get up. Okay? They used to get up and ran around to see whom? Ran forward to see these bakers. And here, the narrator says that usually these bakers used to visit two times our place. One is with full baskets of bread. Okay, basket full of bread as he comes there to sell the bread. The second arrival is after emptying the basket. Okay, so once he moves through this place with basket full of bread for the first time, then in return, after selling all the bread in different places and different areas, they will return in the same, through the same place. So likewise, a father used to visit the village or the place of her narrator two times. Okay, one in the morning and one in the evening. So that's where it says that we children considers this bakers as a friend and companion. That means they like to spend much, children like to spend much time with the baker. Okay, and mainly maybe in the morning time he was very busy selling the bread. The evening time he may be having enough time because his basket is empty after selling all the bread. He'll be returning to his own place through their village. Okay, then emptying his huge basket. The jingling thud of the bamboo wake up from the sleep. Even though already we have said that if the children were sleeping, they never mind. Whenever they hear the jingling sound of this bamboo stick, children used to get up and run towards him to greet him. And here the narrator says that actually I don't know why was it. And he was never not very sure whether it was because of the love of the loaf or not. But he was very sure that always these bakers will be having special bread for children. Okay? And maybe that's one of the reasons children like to spend. They ran towards these bakers. They used to talk with them and they will look for special type of bread. What is that? Here it says that actually the normal or the loaves of bread were bought by Paskines or Bastine. They are the maid servants of the house. They were called Paskine or Bastine. The maid servants of the house were called Paskine or Bastine. But here we see the children, they longed for bread bankers. See, just like a banker, they used to mold, they used to bake bread specially for children. And sometimes they will be sugar coated also. That means sweet bread. So, looking for the sweet bread as well as the bankle shaped bread, who comes there? Children used to comes there and stand beside these bakers. Okay, and now coming to the next paragraph. The baker made his musical entry on the scene with the jung jung sound of his specially made bamboo stuff. One hand supported the basket on the head and the other banged the bamboo on the ground. He would greet the lady of the house with good morning and then place his basket on the vertical bamboo. We kids would be pushed aside with a mild rebuke and the loaves would be delivered to the servant. But we would not give up. We would climb a bench or a parapet and peep into the basket somehow. I can still recall the typical fragrance of those loaves. Loaves for the elders and bangles for the children. Then we did not even care to brush our teeth or wash our mouth properly. And why should we? Who would take the trouble of plucking the mango leaf from the tooth for the toothbrush? And why was it necessary at all? The tigers never brushed his teeth. Hoti would wash and clean up everything so nicely after all. So what happened? Here we see that once the baker arrives. Now the arrival of the baker with a special music. Says that with a musical entry. Already we have seen that they have got a bamboo stick. And they used to just make a thud sound. Okay, and they used to bang. Bang means they used to make a huge, fierce touch with the bamboo stick on the ground. And this banging of these bamboo sticks gives a special music. So once it was heard, we see that already the children will run. And now the posture of the man, the baker, is like, in one hand he'll be having what? The bamboo stick. The other hand will be supporting the basket on his head. Okay, one hand he support the basket on his head and with one hand he bang the bamboo stick on the ground, giving a special music to the people, announcing that who is coming? Baker is coming. Okay, so, and also here we see that once he reached the place, all the people in the house would come out, especially the mistress of the house would come out, and whenever the baker see the mistress of the house, he would greet them by saying what? Good morning. Good morning. And they will choose which bread they want. By the time the servants will buy from them. And the kids who are gathered round there, they will be very eager to look at this one. As he places this basket of bread on the bamboo stick, they couldn't see it well. So what happened? They will rush towards him. Definitely the parents will scold them to move aside, isn't it? The children are very, what is that, naughty ones. They were very eager to look into the basket to see whether their product is there or not. What is their product? Bangle shaped bread. So definitely parents will rebuke here, means scold these children to move a little apart. So when they were scolded, what they would do? They would just climb onto where? Climb onto the parapet or to bench to make sure that their bread is still there in the basket. Okay? And that's where it says that, but we would never give up. We would climb a bench or parapet. Parapet means the side of the house. Okay? To peep, to look into the basket. For what? For their typical type of bread, bangle shaped bread. And the other thing is that it gives a very tempting smell, tempting, very fragrance, a very good fragrance, and that will help the children to have the bread at the very first sight itself. So anyhow, we can see that special laws for elders and bangle loaves for bangle bread for children will be there in the basket. Okay, then the narrator says that once we get this bangle shaped bread, we will never bother about what? Brushing our teeth. The only concern is somehow to eat the bangle bread. So they were very tasty, good smell that will really make the children mad, and definitely they wanted to eat it. And here says that what is the need of brushing your teeth? After all, you can just wash your mouth with a cup of tea, isn't it? While you drink tea or coffee, that will help you to wash your mouth and then you can eat it. And he is asking one more question. How many tigers, elephants, lions are brushing their teeth, isn't it? And moreover, that we see that the narrator says that we don't have time to go and pluck what? Pluck the mango leaf. For what? For brushing your teeth. Instead of toothbrush, you know that in ancient times people use these mango leaves for they will roll it and they will just use it as brush for cleaning their teeth. Okay, so it says that we don't have time to pluck the mango leaves and all. We are very hungry to eat this bangle shaped bread. So it says that why is it necessary? After all, hot tea would wash and clean up everything so nicely. Once you take the bad coffee, then there is no need to brush your teeth. So that's what the narrator says about the baker's bread for the elders, loaves of bread for the elders, and bangle shaped bread for the children. Okay, the children are very much interested. They consider these bakers or pathas as friends, guides and companion. Okay, and the arrival of the bakers can be identified by the thud sound of the bamboo stick. And whenever they hear the thud or the banging sound of the bamboo stick, they will understand that who is there. Baker is there in front of their house. And the narrator remembers that two times he comes to their place. One is for selling, other returning after selling the bread. Okay. Marriage gifts are meaningless without sweet bread known as bowl. Just as party or feast loses its charm without bread. Not enough can be said to show how important a baker can be for a village. The lady of the house must prepare sandwiches on the occasion of her daughter's engagement. Cakes and bolinhas are a must for Christmas as well as other festivals. Thus, the presence of the baker's furnace in the village is absolutely essential. So what we see in this paragraph is the says about the importance of bread in this place, Goa especially. And says that marriages are meaningless without what? Without bread. Especially one special type of bread is known as bowl. Okay. Bowl means sweet bread. This is a picture of bowl. Okay. And this bowl is very important during marriage functions and all. That shows that anyhow, whatever the occasion be, If there is any party, festival, feast, marriages or any occasion, the importance of bread is has great role there. Okay, and now you know that these bakers are very busy in all occasions. Even though there is no occasions like festivals, feast or anything like that, but still then people are very much interested in eating this bread. So especially talking about marriages, you know that no marriage is conducted without what? A bread, a sweet bread known as ball. Okay? And here we see that they says that there is no charm without, there is no happiness, there is no sweetness without a ball in their wedding ceremony or marriage function. And as I said, another important thing is that bakers need to bake this bread, because during marriages, the lady of the house must prepare what? Must prepare sandwiches. Sandwiches are prepared with the use of this bread. Okay, so there also we see that the importance of bread. Bread is necessary to make what? Sandwiches. And also cakes and bolinghas. Bolinghas means this is bolinghas. These bolinghas are cardamom flavored coconut and semolin cake. It's a cookie. It is little crispy. Okay, it's prepared with a semolin and coconut with cardamom flavored and all. Okay, and that also baked by whom? Baked by the bakers or padas. So whatever be during Christmas season, bolinghas and cakes are a part of their Christmas. During marriage function, bowl is very important. Special sweet bread is very important. And especially for wedding parties, ladies used to prepare what? Sandwiches. That is also made with bread. So anyhow, there is no celebration happened in Goa without the presence of bread. So this bakers are having a great role in Goan life. And that's why says that the furnace still exists. The furnace have great importance. Whatever the occasion be, whether it be Christmas, whether it be any other festival, whether it be wedding of the family or whatever be, they needed bread or bolinghas or bowl or whatever. Okay, and for making sandwiches they also need what? Bread. So the importance of bread in Goa is unavoidable. So definitely the bakers are enjoying a very good life, because all throughout their life they have very good business going on there. Okay, coming to the next paragraph. The baker or bread seller of those days had a peculiar dress known as kabai. It was a single piece long frock reaching down to the knees. In our childhood, we saw bakers wearing a shirt and trouser which were shorter than full length ones and longer than half pants. Even today, anyone who wears a half pant which reaches just below the knees invites the comment that he is dressed like a father. Okay, now coming to the dressing code of these bakers or fathers. It says that ancient time, their dressing is known as what? They wear a peculiar type of dress known as kabai. What do you say? Kabai. Okay. And now talking about that kabai. Kabai is a single piece long frock. Okay. From top to near to their knees. It just flows likewise. And they are called, that type of dress is called kabai. It was a single piece long frock reaching down to their knees. But coming to the time of the writer, that's where it says that in our times, and the writer says that in our times, we used to see these padas or these bread makers used to wear what? They used to wear shirt and trouser that reaches just below their knees. Okay, instead of long frock, during the time of the writer, they used to wear shirt and trouser. But the length of the trouser is equal to the length of the frock which was worn by the fathers in olden time, or the length of the kabai and the length of the trouser will be same. So that's where it says that if any people, and now says that these people who wears trouser, the length of the trouser is not too long or not too short. It's not, it's a bit longer than half pants. The length will be equal to that of kabai, reaching just below their knees. And another thing is that if they see anyone, even today, okay, even today, if anyone wears half pant that reaches only below their knee, they will call them as what? Padar. Okay, people just call them, or will say that that man is dressed like a padar. They used to say likewise. So anyhow, the dressing code of these padars or bread makers are, ancient times they used to wear a long frock that reaches near to their, just below their knees. Okay, they are called, that dress is called kabai. But when the time of the writer, these padars or these bakers used to wear what? Shirt and trouser instead of kabai. But the length of kabai and the trouser will be same. And even today, the writer says that if someone wears half pant, the length of the half pant, if it is very just below the knees, they will say that, they used to say that he wears a dress like that of a padar. Or just like that of a baker. Okay, so that's it. Then coming to the last paragraph. The baker usually collected the bills at the end of the month. Monthly accounts used to be recorded on some wall in pencil. Baking was indeed a profitable profession in old days. The baker and his servants always looked happy and prosperous. Their plump physique was an open testimony to this. Even today, any person with a jackfruit-like physical appearance is easily compared to a baker. Okay? So, what we see here is now talking about the payment. Already, we have seen that early morning, these padars used to come to their village with the sound of what? The banging of the bamboo stick. The music, isn't it? Hearing the sound, people know that who arrived there, these padars arrived there. Okay? Now, after selling, says that they only write the amount in a wall, and only once in a while, that is the end of the month, this person, this baker, used to visit the old house for collecting what? For collecting the money. Okay, so once in a month this father used to come around to collect the payment of 1 month's bread, and says that the calculation of 1 month, how many bread that you have brought on date, and the amount will be written where? Written on a wall with pencil. Okay, the price of each selling will be marked with a pencil on the wall. Finally, at the end of the month, this person along with the family used to count it and give the payment. So this is how the payment of the money was made. And sales said, anyhow, this bread business is a profitable one, because all the people are very much interested, and there is no occasion, there is no festival, there is no marriage, or there is no festival without the presence of what? Presence of bread, either for making sandwiches or sweet bread named ball or bolinghas. Everything, all occasion, especially Christmas time, cakes and bolinghas are very special. So this bread business is a profitable one, and says that the family never starved at all. Okay, and the family never starved, and says that even the servants also enjoyed much. Servants here means the people who help this bakers preparing or baking things, they also enjoyed a very good life. And now talking about the appearance, says that their plump physique was open testimony to this. Says that they always looked happy and prosperous. The baker and his family was always happy because they don't lack anything, and they are also very good what we call eaters, isn't it? They, you know, that they taste, they eat. So the whole family members look plump like fat physical appearance, and they are always looked prosperous too. Prosperous means day after day they are just enriching their own life. Okay, so baking was indeed a profitable business, and the family members along with the servants looked happy and prosperous. So the example of their happiness and prosperity is their physique. Physical means physical appearance. Says that even their physical appearance is a testimony. Testimony here means looking at oneself, we can understand that he eats well and he is from a good family that has much food likewise. And says that nowadays, if they see any person with the size of a jackfruit, just like a fat person, they may compare that person to a baker. Okay, so anyhow, this baker may be having a plump, fat size just like that of a jackfruit. Okay, even now, if any person was seen with good weight and fat physique, they will say that he is a baker. It will be compared to a baker. So anyhow, this lesson we have seen all in some total the life of a baker, then how he sells bread, then what are the special breads, isn't it? Then talking about the family, are the bread selling business is a profitable one or not, everything was very clearly said. But one thing we understood, that even today people are very much interested in bread. In which place? In Goa. The Goan life cannot be avoided without bread, especially bol, bolinghas and all. Bangle bread, okay, sweet bread for children. Then loaves of bread. Then anyhow, this type of bread was started gaining popularity from the time of whom? From the time of Portuguese, isn't it? Even now, people are very much interested, and we see that even nowadays, you can see furnace in Goa. And the traditional way how they prepare. The only thing is that they have changed the mode of dressing from kabai to shirt and trouser. Okay, this is what it is said in the lesson A Baker from Goa. I think you understood the lesson Baker from Goa. So that's all for today's class. Have a great day. God bless you. Read the lesson well and try to understand the lesson. Thank you.